Hey, Jeremy, it's Carter. Wangro is pissed. You better talk to him ASAP. Anyways, I didn't call to play messenger boy. I've got the leads for you. You know the ones that almost cost me my job? They're just leads, so play it safe this time. Don't go starting any trouble. Give me a call when you get in. Bye.
Well, I don't know. That's on your end of the deal. If you can't, maybe Carter can.
Yeah, I'm sick. I'm not helpless. I have my resources.
Something you don't.
That's why I like you, Maxie.
Good night, Jeremy.
Wait, you never answered my question.
You never asked.
Max!
Get some rest. Sleep.
I need an update on 10, Jeremy. Don't tell me you forgot about 10. You need to really pick it up on these stories. Don't make me out to be a sucker, Jeremy. And get yourself a cell phone ready. I don't care if you don't like them. I can't keep leaving messages, Jeremy. Call me.
Who is this guy? Some kind of big shot? Wasting my time like this. Five more minutes, Max.
Just relax. Be here. Any minute now.
Who is he? Seriously.
Well.
You don't look so good, Maxie. How are you feeling?
To tell you the truth, I'm not feeling too well right now.
Oh. I think I'm gonna lose this one.
What are you doing out anyway? You know this guy ain't showing up. Let's get out of here. Who was that guy, and why didn't you two talk?
You asked too many questions.
Whatever. So is that it?
I don't know. You tell me.
Later.
Don't forget.
So now we should-
I can't. I think this one's all you, Jeremy. I'm sorry, pal.
You're done? Finished with the job? Jobs? There are two, you know.
Well, it's only for a couple of days. This bug or flu or whatever, it's killing me.
Yeah, but we still have to-
It's actually just you now.
Unfreaking believable. Hey, Max.
What?
Listen, shouldn't I be there? I don't like this idea. Okay, You're right. You're right. It's your decision. Yeah. I'll do that.
Maxie. Oh, if only you could have been there. He was the most beautiful animal I've ever seen. It may have even been the most beautiful thing I've ever laid my eyes on. It was so peaceful, just staring as it glided through the water. Well, maybe next time I will. I can't imagine one of the world's most finest creatures could have killed that man. That's the next step, and I already have a connection. I haven't made contact with him yet, but I'll figure something out. His name was attached to one of marine biologist. I told you, I will figure something out. I'll take a bath on it for now.
Enjoying your day, birthday boy?
Yeah, I sure am. It's not gonna end already, is it?
No, you still have a full day ahead of you. I'm surprised you made it this far to tell you the truth.
Why you say that?
Well, you're always getting yourself close to kill. Remember that day you fell down the waterfall?
It wasn't that high.
Yeah, but you still went rolling down those rocks. Elijah thought you were dead. You're gonna end up in the hospital one day.
My body's still sore from that day.
That's because you're getting older. You know you're an old man now. Don't worry about it though, honey. We'll get older together.
Well, at least I have a couple of kids, a beautiful wife, and a great looking piece of land to show for it.
It's not a bad thing. I didn't mean it in a bad way. You're right. You have a lot to be proud of.
Yeah, I know. But I always feel like something's missing, you know?
Like what?
I don't know. It's just there.
Well, I know you'll find out what it is. Don't worry about it. Speaking of Elijah, it's been kind of quiet since he moved out.
Yeah, a little too quiet.
Maybe we should do something about that, birthday boy.
Hello?
Hello, Mr. Orlick. Richard Ellington of Ellington Corporation here, calling to discuss the sale and or use of your beautiful, luscious 2,000-acre piece of land.
I'm not selling my land. How'd you get my number?
Don't worry, Mr. Orlick. It's all legal, and I can assure you that you won't regret selling to us or at least renting your property to us.
I told you guys already. It's not for sale or rent.
I sent you an email with my contact info and everything you need to know should you consider working with Ellington Corporation.
For the last time, I'm not selling.
What was that about?
Goddamn vultures. They don't get it. It's not for sale or rent or whatever else they keep calling me for.
And why not?
Well, because we're going to build a ranch out there and a big horse stable, like the kinds you had when you were growing up. And I'll take Elijah out there so we can kill some coyotes. Kill them some bitches before they eat our horses. And did I miss anything?
Come here. I love you so much, baby, so much.
I love you too, honey. I'm sorry, honey, I have to be somewhere.
On your birthday, you've got to be somewhere?
Yeah, but I'll be right back. Love you, take care.
Are you tired?
A little.
Hon.
Yeah, babe.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, babe.
So can you really help me, or?
All I can do is collect the facts. I'm not an investigator. I simply collect the facts, and then I hand them off to my superiors. From there, it has a chance of being published. But we're off to a good start. You have facts.
Well, I guess I have a few. I just don't know how much help will be to you, but.
It could be that we're wasting our time. So let's find out.
Okay.
Now, I realized that you were the head researcher on the stingray case.
It wasn't a stingray, it was a manta ray. It's a huge difference, it's where they argued.
Okay. What was so different about this case? I mean, why did they feel the need to kick you off of it?
The manta ray. It wasn't a stingray, it was different, but yet it had a spine at the base of its tail. It wasn't a stingray, you get it? There's a whole new species of manta ray, and I discovered it. They wanted the credit, so I got the boot.
Now, who exactly do you work for? I mean, do you have a name or two?
Sorry, I can't think right now. This just really upsets me. I'm sorry.
No problem. Just take your time. Philip, excuse me for asking this, but it might be important for me to know. Now, you look like a pretty young guy. Why are you hooked up to this respirator?
I don't know. I mean, one day I'm fine, and next I'm coughing up blood. I just don't have time to figure out what's what. It's just been very busy. I mean, who knows?
Okay. I was just wondering. So, any names?
Well, I guess I should tell you about this, too. Even though I don't know too much about it myself.
What? Tell me about what?
It's okay. I know it's of interest to you, and you might be able to figure out why it's like this.
You know what? I'm sorry.
Oh, don't be sorry. Just look. You see? You see, it's not really a hand. I mean, it is, but it's only made up of three digits. And it's not like, it's like they're a group of fingers making up one whole finger. Here, there, and there. You see that, right?
Yeah.
Just look at it. His name is Richard Ellington. I was the only one certified to enter that room. They're screwed without me in there.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Brian.
Oh, don't worry about it. It's fine.
How are things at the shop?
Good, good. Things are going as planned, you know.
So, Brian,
Yeah?
Did you already do something about the,
Yes, I did.
He didn't dig too far, did he?
Oh, no. No, he's bright, but he's not that bright. I mean, you should hear what he thought happened. I mean, that guy is something else.
You'll keep an eye on him, won't you?
We're already on it.
You always run a tight ship, Brian.
Well, I try my best.
was he hiding?
Hello? Yeah, this is him. What do you want? I already told you to. I'm the only person who knows where those tapes are, and it's gonna stay that way. That was part of the deal. Yeah, they gave me that story. Why? Is there something important that I should know about him? Or is there something important that I shouldn't know about him? No, Max had nothing to do with it, so leave him out of it. Larry Orlick. He owns a piece of land, or owned a piece of land. And for some reason or another, he went missing on his land. His own land. Of course, no one knows why, he just did. He left his son behind and his estranged wife. Now Larry lives in a crazy house.
Sorry, Matthew. It's been getting worse lately.
Don't worry about it, Richard.
So how are you doing this fine September, this fine day in September?
Doing pretty good. I'll be fixed up here in a minute, but every time we open this, it is not good.
All I can do is hope that this is the last time. Matthew.
Yes.
That guy was working for Brian. Philip. I heard he was talking about 3 weeks ago.
Yeah, I know. Russ knows too.
I don't think it's, I don't think it's anything to worry about, but keep Russ on it. He'll let you know if it needs worrying.
Hello?
There's some really messed up things going on, and I don't quite know how to describe what I saw over there. Something must be in the air. It's almost as if even the animals have been affected by what's happening. Thank you.
And this was where?
About 15, 20 miles out. I guess I was in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Well, are you gonna tell anyone about it? Jeremy?
So did you dig up any more information on Larry Orlick? Maybe something about his son? What about this Richard Ellington character?
I have a few facts. Do you think this is somehow related to Orlick's job?
I don't know. And that strange man before that who put a dent in my car.
Thanks, Max. If you can send me all the information you have on Larry and anything else.
Oh, yeah, no problem. I actually sent it out not too long ago. You good to drive?
Yeah. I don't know that my car is. It's in pretty bad shape. But anyway, take care. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah, I think it's about time. Just dump all of it. I mean, just get rid of all of it. Yeah, dump it over there somewhere, anywhere, I don't care. God, we thank you so much, Sam. You know, you're doing a big favor for Richard. He's not gonna forget you for this, don't worry about that. Well, yeah, exactly. Well, take care, don't get your hands too dirty. Hey, I'm serious. Well, be safe. Bye.
Okay, babe, we gotta go. I'll see you again later. Not any sooner.
Okay. Take care.
I don't know.
Come on, it'll be fun.
You know, I took the day off from work just to hang out with you in the park.
I still want to hang out in the park. I'm just saying.
You're just saying you don't want to hang out in the park.
No, I'm just saying I want to do something different. Come on, Larry, I really want to go.
I don't know. It's a little too risky for me, X. I mean, it's almost lunchtime.
Exactly, it's lunchtime. We'll go get something to eat. I know the perfect place.
No, it's not such a good idea.
How was your birthday?
It was nice.
Did you like my gifts?
Yeah, I did.
Both of them? Good, I'm really glad. So can we go? Please?
This is it.
like it. Is this Elijah?
Yeah.
Funny, you guys don't look alike.
Kind of strange, huh?
Yeah. What about...
Her pictures are upstairs. All right, you see my house, let's go.
Wait, I haven't seen your kitchen yet. Nice kitchen. You ever cook?
Once in a while when Eli visits. Exus, the clock is ticking. My wife's gonna be home any minute.
Come on, Larry, give me a second, please. Now, let's check out your bedroom.
My bedroom?
Where's your bedroom? It's gorgeous.
My wife does have good taste.
It shows.
Nexus.
All right, fine, we'll leave.
That's more like it.
Can I use your bathroom?
Yeah, use the one upstairs.
Okay.
And hurry up.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh no. What are you doing, X? My wife's gonna be home any minute. This isn't funny.
When is this going to pay off?
Matthew, I believe the geese are thawed out now. How about you feed those dice to the kids? Only the best for ours.
Are you okay?
I need your phone.
Yeah. Come on. Wait, wait.
So, the phone is over here.
Wait. I just need to lie down for a minute.
Okay.
going on in there?
Sit here all night if you have to.
Richard, I think we finally got something.
Yeah, I do. For some odd reason, now don't ask me why, I think Elijah's key to some of this. Maybe not directly, but in one way or another. Yeah, I can hold on. I haven't read them yet. I don't know who you know, but thanks. Well, we've hit a dead end with the Stingray case. Let's just put it aside for now. All right, I know. I'm heading north right now for 10. Relax. We just started research, and you're already nervous. It's just started, Maxie. Don't freak out now. Not yet. Okay, bye. There was plenty of information on those papers. Information that I probably shouldn't have read or had access to. I really need to speak to Elijah.
My dad in the mental hospital and poisoned his land. They follow me sometimes.
Are you feeling okay, Elijah?
Yeah. Yeah, just a little upset about all this. I'm having a hard time with the reality of this. I don't know how I should feel right now.
You want to tell me a little bit about your father? About both of you guys?
Not really. But if you think it'll help, then okay. And I think it will. Because my father was a good man. Is a good man. He just made a decision to work with a not so good man. Do you know he's a good man, Jeremy? Do you know he's a good man? He's a good man, Jeremy. Do you know that?
Elijah, so do you want to tell me a little bit about your relation to your father?
Not really. But Jeremy?
Yeah?
Do you think my father was a good man? I mean, from all the research that you've done, I think you'd know a few things.
From the little bit that I do know, I would say that he's a good man. I just think that he made a decision to work with, well, not so good men. What's so funny?
I remember when we used to go hunting, and he knew I just went for the fun and not for the sport of it. But if we'd have a leftover sandwich or two, he'd throw them on the ground and shoot them. Turkey would fly into a million pieces and fly everywhere. Yeah, I remember that. It's just hard to see him now in that condition.
Who are the people who put him in that condition? I know they fought really hard to keep their names out of the paper.
I'm very reluctant to say. But maybe if I talk quietly, they won't be able to hear. Richard Ellington.
Ellington?
Yeah. He still goes out and visits the land sometimes. I can't even believe he has the audacity to. I go out there and watch him. I watch him on his stupid wheelchair. And I feel so powerless to do anything about it, because he's always got his cronies with him. I mean, I don't want to hurt him or anything. I just want to do to him what he did to my father. Meryl Argus.
Hmm?
Meryl Argus. He used to visit my father's house all the time. For some reason, he would go to my father's land all the time. I haven't seen him for a while, though. Maybe he's lost out there.
I knew you mentioned earlier that they would follow you. Is there a particular reason why, or are they just giving you trouble?
I don't think that. I don't know. I even asked one of them one time, but they wouldn't tell me.
You asked one of them?
One of Ellington's cronies was sneaking through my house. Can you believe that? I can't. He hasn't answered me yet.
You asked him after that?
I ask him all the time, but still nothing. Here, maybe if you ask him, he'll tell us. You can ask him, Jeremy. Maybe he'll only tell certain people.
What do you mean I can ask him?
He doesn't like to talk while he's having his seizures, though.
Jesus Christ! What the hell's going on, Elijah?
Come on, Jeremy.
He's seizing on the floor.
I caught him while he was going through my...
He's foaming at the mouth!
It's okay. He lives with me now. I don't hurt him or anything if that's what you're thinking.
I don't even know what I'm thinking. I gotta get out of here. Thanks for cooperating. I gotta go.
Jeremy, wait. You forgot your little voice recorder.
Thanks.
Jeremy, wait. You forgot your little voice recorder.
Thanks.
Are you one of the people who uses the voice recorder so they can...
Elijah, I want to tell you, no, maybe I must tell you, that I read what seemed to be a will from your father, stating that his land will be yours someday, eventually. I found and read the agreement papers between Merrill and your father, the papers Merrill signed in order to get access to your dad's land. Merrill Argus might know something. Didn't you tell me that earlier? Elijah. Elijah.
I don't know what happened to me. I've been here too long. Merrill is out there, somewhere.
Merrill! Merrill, is that you? Merrill!
Max. Hey, Max, you in there? Hey, the door is open. I'm coming in.
I don't know what happened to Max or who did it. I guess I will be finishing these jobs alone.
Jeremy, I just want to tell you something. I mean it, Jeremy. I've got 2 glass bottles in my hands. I don't have to use them. You're in a lot of trouble if you don't quit snooping around, Jeremy. Mind your business. And most importantly, stay out of ours. Oh, that first picture you took of me? That one's free. The next one might cost you.
My work. It's been getting dangerous lately. I don't know if I can keep doing this anymore, but I need to know what's happening and why.
name is Richard Ellington. I was the only one certified to enter that room.
I mean, I don't want to hurt him or anything. I just want to do to him what he did to my father. Meryl Argus. Mm-hmm. Meryl Argus. He used to visit my father's house all the time.
Come on, Elijah, pick up, pick up. Elijah, hi, it's Jeremy. Hey, I really need your help. I need you to tell me where your dad is living, and I need you to get me a visit with him. Hello? Hello? Elijah, are you there? Damn it. Hello, Elijah?
Jeremy? Didn't Matthew warn you?
Who is this? Who's Matthew?
I think you know who this is, Jeremy. Research is free, but sharing it will always cost you, or the lives of others.
Hello?
Jeremy, are you okay? I didn't mean to be so abrupt about it. I should apologize for that. Maybe I should get straight to the point. I have no idea who or where your family is. It's possible that, for all I know, they live in another country. So I can't lie to you. And I tell you, for their sake, you need to quit and leave us alone. But Jeremy, you do need to stop what you're doing. Jeremy? Are you still listening?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Jeremy. I know this is your job, but you can't compromise mine. Do you understand what I mean, Jeremy?
Yes.
Okay, good. Again, let me get straight to the point. I want to make this short and sweet. You need to meet me somewhere soon. I would like to have a talk with you face to face.
Can we talk like this?
Over the phone is no way to discuss something as important as what I would like to talk to you about.
But where do you want to meet?
Thank you for cooperating, Jeremy. You won't regret it. I think it's best that we meet on the outskirts of my land, or Larry's land as it stands right now. Technically, it's his land still, but I'm just leasing it. But anyways, we should meet 3 days from now.
Where exactly do you want me to meet you?
When you make your way over here, give me a call on your cell phone and I'll let you know.
I don't have a cell phone. I hate cell phones.
Okay, if you don't own a cell phone, then please use a payphone on the way over there. Is this something you can do, Jeremy?
Yes.
Sounds good. I look forward to meeting you, Jeremy. Talk to you soon.
Thanks for coming out here, Jeremy. Glad to finally meet you, face to face.
Funny, you and Philip have the same oxygen tank and mask. Is your hand all screwy too?
I want to let you know that I'm human too, Jeremy. No matter what you might think, I am not I am not a monster, Jeremy.
I don't care to hear you try to convince me the way you've convinced yourself. I do not care what you have to say.
No, I think you do care. You want to hear what I have to say, don't you, Jeremy?
What do you mean?
I think you know where this conversation is heading. It bothers you that I know how you work.
You don't know anything about me. You're just some poor freak in a wheelchair. But soon, everyone will know everything about you.
Why, what's up?
Honey, I was thinking since I have a little bit of time, maybe we could take a shower together. You know, I've had a rough day. It could help me blow off a little steam.
Actually, you know, I was just going to be in and out. I don't...
Oh, come on! Let me in there!
No, listen, just hold on a second. I think my migraines are coming back.
What do you mean? You stopped getting migraines years ago. Come on, you're wasting my lunch break. Let me in.
Fun stuff.
Don't be so stubborn.
Please, just quit it.
You're so stubborn.
Stop it.
No.
Please, stop.
What's your problem, Larry?
I just don't want to have sex with you. Hey, Exus, what's up? Not too busy, why? What's going on? No, she didn't. Thanks for your concern. I don't know right now. I guess not. I don't know. I guess not. Exus, just stop. Honestly, yeah. I do. Okay. You know. Yeah, that might be good. We could talk about what happened. All right, bye. Hello? Hello?
Hello, Mr. Orlick. Richard Ellington of Ellington Corporation here.
Calling... I thought I told you to stop calling me.
Yeah, I do.
Look, it's beautiful out there. There's so much land. It would be so much work.
It is beautiful. Larry?
Yeah. Hey, hon, check it out. I'm almost done with the structure.
I want a divorce.
Hello? Yeah, I have a few minutes. That I certainly am. This is quite unexpected of you. I thought I was going to have to bring out the big guns. Straight to the point, huh? 5 p.m. is fine. Bye.
Get the food out!
On one condition. When I die, my son gets deeds to the land. You can do whatever you want now, but when I'm gone, my son earns the rights.
So what was really going on in the ocean when that man got stung to death by that manta, stingray, whatever it was? Philip seemed to be kept out of the loop on that one.
That was never supposed to happen.
You were dumping waste, chemical waste into the ocean. What did you expect to happen?
I did not expect that to happen. It was a manta turned into some kind of...
mutant? Just like what you're becoming. Little by little.
I guess we both are.
We? You're the one in the wheelchair here. I would never get involved with what you were doing.
No, you wouldn't. But you did get involved. And, well, that's why Max is no longer with us. You should really be careful, Jeremy.
Yeah, and so should you. I bet you can guess some of the stuff I found out from Elijah and what Larry left behind.
Stop. Just hold it. You know, you're not telling me anything I don't already know. Why don't you tell me something I don't know? Like, did you ever find Meryl Argus? I didn't think so. In fact, I'm surprised you even made it that far.
The wolf. That was you.
Apparently, you had a guardian angel watching over you. It's probably good you didn't meet up with Meryl. It wouldn't have been good for either of us. In the center, in the very core of this land, there is something going on right now. Something I hadn't planned, but I can't stop it. Everyone could be affected. Which brings me to the whole point of why I brought you out here to begin with. You need to stop what you're doing, Jeremy. Just forget about it. Just forget about everything. You know what I mean, Jeremy?
I think I have an idea. What are you trying to do here? Get to the point.
The fact is, I don't know where you're keeping all the tapes. The tapes and all the other documents. I don't know where you're keeping them. If I did, they'd be in my hands.
Yeah? And I'm keeping it that way.
Fine. I'm not asking for them. I don't care. I just want to make you a deal. Do me a favor, Jeremy. Keep everything you've gathered. All the documents, the recordings, anything you've recorded here today. In a safe place. Although, I'm pretty sure you've been doing that. If you do that for me, you'll be set for good. No more problems. Plenty of cash flow. Things that maybe you wanted, you can now have. Can you do that for me, Jeremy? God, you know, Jeremy, I can't help thinking about what happened to your friend Max.
Quit talking about Max! Tell me what was in room 850B! What was happening?
Okay, I accept your offer.
Sorry about that. I hope he's not hurt too bad. You guys caught me in a transitional period of my life. I guess it doesn't matter now.